Hi everyone, let us start with a new chapter today called Political Parties from your civics. And this lesson is basically about describing the political parties and how they run and what are the responsibilities of all the political parties. So a political party is a group of people who come together to contest election and hold power in the government. So they contest elections and they are the one who hold the power in the government, and they agree some policies and programs for the society with a view to promote the collective good. So parties reflect fundamental political divisions in a society. So they have the political divisions of a society, and they are about a part of the society and thus involve in partisanship. So thus a party is known by which part it stands for, which policy it supports, and whose interest it upholds. So see, sometimes the parties may also be religion based, language based. So these are called as the support which they show and their interests. And there are few policies which have different interest and different types of partisanships. Okay, so that based on that only the political parties are differentiated, and the political party has three different components: the leaders, the active members, and the followers. So as you know, the leaders of the party, the active members, and the followers of the party. If you see, like in our Indian constitution or in our country itself, you have several different parties of which you have different leaders, who is the leader of the party and also who have their own followers. So one who support one party will not support, like how you have in Tamil Nadu, you have DMK and ADMK and all that. You have followers for that specific parties, and they will, those who follow this will not follow that. So they are the specific followers. And what is the necessity for the political parties? If there were no political party, then each and every candidate would be independent. And current strength of Lok Sabha is 543. Imagine a situation when none of 543 members can be brought to think alike on a particular issue. So there is a situation in which you cannot bring all this 543 to think alike. Okay, if there is a particular issue, and if this 543 people are going to discuss on something, and all 543 do not have the same thinking, an independent candidate would always be more interested in the specific need of the interest of a nation. A specific need of his constituency, and would seldom think about the larger interest of the nation. So if there is an independent candidate who always come to Lok Sabha for the meeting, that would always be more interested in specific needs. So there will be specific need for that independent person than concentrating on the interest of the whole country. And a political party is necessary to bring diverse people on a common platform so that bigger issues can be taken off. The democracy which is being practiced all over the world is called representative democracy. So the form of government, that is, democracy is nothing but the form of government which is being practiced all over the world, is called as a representative democracy. And in this system you have governance which is done through people's representative, that is, one who is selected by the people. That is, he is called as the people's representative, because it is impossible for each citizen to directly participate in governance. The need for representative democracy has given rise to political parties. So the need for selecting a specific leader has led to the political parties, formation of political parties. Functions of a political party. First function is contesting election. So they have to contest election, and then they have to nominate themselves as a candidate for the electoral contest in various constituency. And policies, they have political parties put forward different policies and programs so that the voters can choose from them. So whoever is going to vote for this party, they choose from the options that is given by the political party, and which brings a large number of similar opinions under one umbrella. Meaning everything is brought under one category. Under one umbrella is nothing but under one category. These opinions are channelized to form policies and programs. Okay, so these the whole of the opinion is channelized to form policies and programs, and the policies and programs of the ruling party are expected to be followed by the government. So whatever the policies and the programs are being designed by the ruling parties, that is said to be followed by the government. Making law. Okay, the third one is making law. Political parties play a decisive role in making law for the country. You may be aware that it is the legislature which passes a law after proper debate, as most of the members belong to the political parties. So a political party has direct say in lawmaking for the country. So making law, how political parties has the right to make law. Political parties play a very important role in making law for the country, and we are also aware that it is the legislature which passes the law after proper debate. That is, once a law is designed and there will be a debate which is conducted among different parties to find out whether this one is worth and this one is applicable for the country, and then this law will be passed by the legislator. As most of the members belong to the political parties, so political party has direct say in lawmaking for the country. Formation of a government. So political parties form and run governments. The executive body is formed by people from the ruling party. So various political leaders are assigned different ministries to carry out the tasks of governance. So they parties form and run government. So the executive body is formed. Executive body is the various department of a country is given a leader. That is, there will be a specific leader of that specific party who will be given that department. Education department, you have natural disaster department. So like this, everyone will take one responsibility who will carry out the governance. Playing opposition, a party which does not get majority come under the majority coalition. They need to play the role of opposition. So who are those one specific political group which is not being selected, which is not having majority vote. So that group is called as the opposition of the majority group. Shaping public opinion. They shape the public opinion, and they do so by rising and highlighting issues in legislature and in the media. Access to the government machinery and welfare schemes. Parties provide people access to government machinery and welfare schemes, since it is easy to approach local party leader than government officers. So it's not possible to directly go and reach the government officers. Instead, what people do is they go and meet the party leaders with their issues in order to rectify those issues. Different party systems. One party system. So under different party system, you have the first one, which is one party system. In some countries, only one party is allowed to control and run the government. These are called as one party system. For example, in China, only the Communist Party is allowed to rule. That is only one party is allowed to control the whole government of that country. So that is called as one party system. For example, you have China. Then comes the two-party system. In some countries, power is shared between two main parties. Such party system is called as two-party system. There are only two parties among which the governance should be selected. So whichever party is winning, that party will be the responsible one for running the government. So the United States of America and the United Kingdom are the examples of two-party system. And there are multiple party system, in which several parties compete for power and more than two parties have reasonable chance of winning. We call it as multi-party system. In India, we have multi-party system. As you know, there are different parties in India and they all register themselves for the election. And they all stand for the election, and whoever is going to be selected by the voters, they will get the power. Since multi-party system tend to offer more choices to the voters, it is often considered better than the other party systems. So you have multi-party system in which you have many people competing with each other. So options are more. That is why people go for multi-party system, and they also feel that it is beneficiary than the other two, one or two-party system. So comparison between two-party system and multi-party system, you have two-party system present voter a simple choice, but here in multi-party system, they have many choices. And two-party system provide a stable governance, but government is not stable in multi-party system. And in two-party systems, it is not flexible because they have more or less a rigid set of opinion on every issue. But whereas multi-party system has more responsive to a change or a shift in a public opinion. So example of two-party system is USA and UK. An example of multi-party system is India. And there are national parties. A party that secures at least 6% of the total votes in Lok Sabha election or assembly election in 4 states and wins at least 4 seats in the Lok Sabha, which is recognized as the national party. So which is called as a national party? A party which secures 6% of the vote in Lok Sabha election and or in other way, they have in assembly election in 4 states and win at least 4 seats in Lok Sabha. That party is recognized as the national party. So recognized national parties in India are BJP, Indian National Congress, Communist Party of India, Marxist. First one is Marxist Communist Party of India, and then Communist Party of India, Bahujan Samaj Party, Nationalist Congress Party. And the state parties, a party that secures at least 6% of the total vote in an election to the legislative assembly of a state and wins at least 2 seats. Okay, so it is state wise. So they have to have at least 6% of the total vote in an election to the legislative assembly of a state, and they have to win at least 2 seats. This is recognized to be a state party. Recognized state parties in India. There's a whole list of state parties which is given here. You can go through it. Around 49 state parties present here. Okay, see like how you have different states, and for each state you have many different parties competing with each other. So you have 49 state parties which is listed here, and I think you can go through the year and the names of those people who are ruling the parties. If men be good, government cannot be bad. This is a famous quote which tells that if men be good, that is the one who's the leader is good, and they say that the government of that place cannot be bad. Challenges to a political party. Let's see what are the challenges to a political party.